I don't think John wants to say more beyond that because his case is still ongoing. Yeah, yeah, yeah. And what he has told us is he thinks his t-shirt says what he wants to say the most.
That says it all, huh? Yeah. Well, what do you have to say about the stats of the case, Emily?
John has been wrongly imprisoned for 36 and a half years. He is free today for the first time in 36 and a half years. His case is still going on. And we will continue to fight for John Floyd.
Long road. This, what, 36 and a half years is a long time, and then this IPNO appeal is taking quite a while.
We've represented John Floyd since 2004. That's right. Yes.
How does it feel to get to this point?
I think it's a relief more than anything. You know, we believe John was innocent from day one on this case. I think there is, you know, that's forensic evidence that shows it. And it's just a big relief for John to actually be able to walk out of prison.
John, is there anything you're looking forward to doing?
A lot of John's family died while he was in prison. John comes from a large family, and many of them have died in the 36 and a half years that John has been in prison. He is looking forward to visiting with those who are still alive. And John has worked very, very hard since he's been in prison. He was one of the most trusted inmates. He worked every day that he was there. He helped rebuild New Orleans after Hurricane Katrina. He was handpicked by the warden to come as one of the most trusted inmates to help with the rebuilding effort. And every day, every time we visit John, what he says is, I want to get out so I can get to work. So John is looking forward to starting work. He already has a job set up, and the place he's going to live is so that he can work at that job on a farm outside Lafayette. John is very good with animals, and he loves animals, and he's going to continue doing what he's been doing, which is working hard, working with animals, working to make a living.